Learn and play.
ألعب وأتعلم.
هيا بنا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن شاء الله تعالى today we will be reading سورة الإخلاص and we will be as well understanding what's the meaning of سورة الإخلاص. I will recite it first and then after that each one of you إن شاء الله تعالى will recite it. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Now ظاهر، can you please read سورة الإخلاص؟
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
بارك الله فيك. من الله bless you. Now سامح.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
ما شاء الله. Do you know what's the meaning of سورة الإخلاص? Yeah. And why is it named, Allah named it to be سورة الإخلاص? Now let's explain سورة الإخلاص and the meaning of it. Allah عز وجل stated in the Quran, قل هو الله أحد. Allah is saying to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, say Allah عز وجل is one and unique. Allah is one. There is no one else. There is no God but Allah alone with no partners. And Allah is unique. There is no one similar to Allah Azza wa Jal. There is no one equal to Allah Azza wa Jal. Then Allah said, Allahu Samad. Allahu Samad here, the meaning of it, that Allah, that all the creation relies on Allah and they are in need for Allah's support and help. And Allah doesn't, is self-sufficient, doesn't need any of his creation. Then Allah made it very clear, لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. The meaning of this, that he doesn't begets, nor he was begotten. He doesn't, Allah doesn't have children, and Allah عز وجل doesn't have father, meaning that he wasn't, Allah wasn't, doesn't begets children, and he wasn't begotten by fathers or mothers. Allah, that's why, because Allah is one and unique. And then Allah said, وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدْ. And there is no one similar or equal to Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, do you know that the meaning of Surah Al-Ikhlas, it is that, why is it named Surah Al-Ikhlas? That it, because it talks about Tawheed. Do you know what's Tawheed? Do you know what's Tawheed, yeah. Allah? What's Tawheed?
Let Tawheed me, is Allah.
Allah is one. Tawheed in Islam means to worship no one except Allah. No one except Allah, and as well to believe that Allah Azza wa Jal is the creator of everything, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the controller of all affairs, and Allah is the one who owns everything, and that's why Allah, he is the only one deserved to be worshipped alone. No one else deserves to be worshipped. That's why Surah Al-Ikhlas, it means, it comes from Ikhlas meaning sincerity, and that means that we have to worship Allah Azza wa Jal with sincerity. We have to be sincerely and we have to be faithfully to Allah alone with no partners. Now, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, say Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, yeah. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what he said about this surah, he said Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that if you, do you want to recite, are you able to recite the third of the Quran? You see this Quran? Can you recite every night the third of the Quran, the third of it? Can you do that, Zahir, every night? It's difficult, isn't it? Even though some people, they can do it. But the Prophet ﷺ, he has made it easy for us. He said, alayhi salatu wasalam, he said that if someone recited Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحْدٍ, every night, as if, as he has recited the third of the Quran, that it is similar to the third of the Quran, like in terms of the ajr, and the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal, that it is like the third of the Quran. So that's why the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, Can anyone amongst you to recite the third of the Quran? Some of the companions, they said they might not able to recite the third of the Quran. And some they were able to recite. But he said, if someone recited قُلُ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدَ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ as if as he has recited the third of the Quran. Do you know why it is similar to the third of the Quran? Now, what the Quran has? The Quran, the scholars of Islam, they said, the Quran has, it contains three main things. Firstly, Tawheed. You know the Tawheed which I was explaining? It has, it is about oneness Allah Azza wa Jal, to single out Allah Azza wa Jal in the matters of worship. To worship none but Allah, alone with no partners. So that's the third, like the third of the Quran. Another portion of the Quran, that it has about ruling. Allah is telling us, for example, to pray, to fast, you know, and to make wudu. And, you know, the ruling of the Quran, things which is halal, things which is haram. So these are ruling mentioned in the Quran. And the third category of the Quran, which Quran contains, it's about the stories of the people before and the people that will be coming after until the Day of Judgment. And even at the time of the Day of Judgment, and people of Jannah and people of the Hellfire. So Allah is telling us stories about them. So Allah told us of the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, about Isa alayhi salam, about Musa alayhi salam in the Quran. So these are stories in order for us to learn those people who worship Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah has promised them Jannah. And the one who doesn't worship Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah promised them that they're going to be punished in the Hellfire. So we have to worship Allah Azza wa Jal, and we have to follow the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Surah Al-Ikhlas, it is equivalent to what? To the third of the Quran, because it has Tawheed, it has oneness Allah Azza wa Jal in the matters of worship. You know, one companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in every rak'ah when he is praying in the salah, he was reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas in every single rak'ah. Even he would recite Fatiha, and then he would recite another surah, and then he would recite Surah Al-Ikhlas in every single rak'ah. And then the Sahaba and the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him. They said to him, "O Messenger of Allah, you know such and such, he is our reciter, he is always leading the salah, and he is always reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas in every single rak'ah." And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to them, "Ask him, why does he do that?" So they went and asked him, "Why do you do that?" And then he said, "Because I find the attribute of Ar-Rahman in this surah, the attribute of Allah in this surah, the attribute of the merciful one in this surah." And then they went back to the Prophet and they said to him, "He is reciting this surah because he found the attribute of Ar-Rahman, the attribute of the merciful one in this surah." And then the Prophet, do you know what he said? Because of this action, you know what he said to them? He said, "Then tell him that Allah Azza wa Jal loves him. Allah loves the one who loves Surah Al-Ikhlas. And the one who always recites Surah Al-Ikhlas. And the one who always implements Surah Al-Ikhlas in worshipping Allah alone with no partners. And knowing the meaning of Surah Al-Ikhlas as well." Yes? So I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless both of you, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to increase you on knowledge and iman, and we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to unite us with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jannat al-Firdaws. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
Jazakumullah khair.